Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In our last two videos on topology, we had defined the concept of topology and also discussed the discrete and indiscrete topologies. In today's video, we shall be looking at open, closed, and clopen sets. Definition: open sets. Let X tau be a topological space. Then the members of tau are said to be open. For instance, if X is a non-empty set with the elements A, B, C, D, E, and F, and tau is a topology on X with members X, phi, A, C, and D. Of course, we can easily verify that X tau, the pair, is a topological space. Now, the members, what now are open sets? The members of the topology tau, X, the empty set, A, and CD are called open sets of the topological space. So if we are asked now, how many open sets do we have, on this space? There would be one, that's the first open set, the second open set, the third open set, and the fourth open set. So there are four open sets in this topological space. One, X, the empty set, the singleton set A, and the set C and D. So members of the topology are called open sets. Definition: closed sets. Let X tau be a topological space. A subset G of X is said to be a closed set in the topological space X tau if its complement in X, namely X slash G, or we can write X minus G, is open in X tau. So we see here that G needs to be a subset of X and not on the topology tau. So in other words, we can simply say that a set G is closed if it is open in what? In X tau. Let us give an example now to illustrate what a closed set looks like. So we have a set X with elements A, B, C, and a topology tau defined on X with open sets phi x a and b. There are four open sets here, 1, 2, 3, 4. The question says we should find all closed sets in the topological space X and tau. Of course, it can easily be verified that this pair X tau is a topological space, but the question here is we should find all the what? Closed sets. Now, like from definition, we say that a subset G of X is said to be closed in this space if its complement in X is open. What are we saying? So that means to investigate what closed sets, to investigate the closed sets in this space, we must first of all, get to know the subsets of X. Of course, the elements of tau or the open set of tau are also subsets of X. However, these are not all the subsets of X. Since X has three elements, then X must have 2^3 what? Subsets, which is equal to what? 8. So the power set of X must contain 8 subsets, which are as follows. So these are all the subsets of the non-empty set X with elements A, B, and C. And of course, if you have been following up the lectures, you should note by now that this is also a topology on X. And this topology is called the discrete topology because it's the largest topology that can be defined on the non-empty set what? X. Now we want to find out which of these subsets of X is closed in the topological space X and what? Tau. We pick the first subset, which is the empty set. So empty set. We want to check what is the complement of the empty set. So what is X minus what? Empty. Complement. Complement simply means what are the elements that are in X that are not in the complement, that are not in the empty set. Of course, X minus empty is nothing but what? X. So the complement of the empty set is X, this whole set itself. The next question is this set X an element of the topology tau? You now check. X is in the topology tau. X is here. So since X is in tau, it now follows that what? Phi is what? Is closed. Is closed. Next, we pick the second subset, which is X, and find its complement in the set. So x minus x will be what? So x minus x, of course, will be empty. It's obvious. We now check if this subset is in tau. Of course, empty is in tau. Therefore, the subset x is closed. We pick the next subset, which is A, and check the complement. So x minus A, what will it be? X is A, B, C minus A. What is left? B and C. B and C. We now check if this element B, C, if this set B, C is in tau. B, C is not in tau. So the subset A is not closed. We pick the next subset B to check again. So X minus B, the complement. So X minus B, X is A, B, C minus B. What is left? A and C equal to A, comma C. We now check if AC is in tau. AC is not in tau. So the subset B is again not closed in the topological space X tau. We pick the next subset, which is C, and check again. X minus C. This would be X minus C, ABC minus C. We have AB left. Is AB in tau? Yes, AB is in tau. Since AB is in tau, it follows that the subset C in question is what? Closed in X tau. We pick the next subset AB and check. What is X minus AB? X minus AB. X is ABC minus AB. What is left is C. Is C in tau? C is not in tau. So the subset AB again is not what? Closed. The next one is BC. We pick B and C and check again. X minus BC. So X is ABC minus BC. We have A left. Is A in tau? Yes, A is in tau. Since A is in tau, BC, the subset BC, is what? Is closed. The next one, or the last one, AC, pick AC. We now check the complement X minus AC. X minus AC, X is ABC minus AC. What is left is B. Is B. We now check if B is in tau. B is not in tau. So the subset AC, once again, is what? Not closed. So of all the eight subsets of the topological space X tau as defined here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 closed sets, and we have 4, you know, sets that are not closed. Now take note, the fact that they are not closed does not mean that they are open. Clopen sets. Now for clopen sets, if a subset of, you know, X, the non-empty set X, is both closed and open, then the subset is said to be what? Clopen. Let us see. We want to check which of these subsets of X is clopen. That is to say, we want to check which of these subsets of X is both open and closed. The first subset of X is phi, the empty set. So we check, is phi open? To check if phi is open, all we have to do is to check if phi is in the topology tau. So tau is this. Is phi in tau? Yes, phi is in tau. Since members of tau are called open sets and phi is in tau, it follows that phi is an open set. So phi is open. The next thing is phi closed? We check. Phi was said to be closed. Phi is closed. Since phi is closed and open, it follows that phi is what? A clopen set. The next subset of X is what? X itself. So is X open? We check tau. If X is in tau, yes, X is in tau. So X is open. Is X closed? We check. If the complement of X was closed, X complement was phi, and phi was closed because phi is in tau. So phi, so X is closed, X again is closed. So since X is closed and both open and closed, X is called clopen. The next subset of X is a singleton set A. Is A open? We check tau. A is in tau, so A is open. We tick for open. Is A closed? We check. A was not closed, so A is not a closed set. Why? Because its complement is not in tau. Since A is open and not closed, A is not clopen. The next subset is B. Is B open? We check tau. B, there's no B in tau, so B is not open. Is B closed? We check. B is not closed. Since B is not open and not closed, B is not clopen. The next subset is C. Is C an open set? We check tau. C is not in tau, so C is not open. Is C closed? We check C. C is closed. C closed. C is not open but closed. C is not clopen. We check AB. Is AB open? We check. Yes, AB is in tau, so AB is open. Is AB closed? We check. AB is not closed. Since AB is open and not closed, AB is not clopen. We check the last one. We check BC. Is BC open? There's no BC in tau, so BC is not open. Is BC closed? We check. BC is closed. Is BC clopen? BC is not what? Clopen. The last one is AC. Is AC open? We check tau. There's no AC in tau, so AC is not open. Is AC closed? We check AC. AC is not closed. AC is both not open and closed. Hence, AC is not what? Clopen. So what do you observe here? You observe that of all the 8 subsets, you know, of the set X with elements A, B, C, only 2 of the sets are clopen, because only 2 of the sets are both open and closed. Meanwhile, we had 4 of the sets being closed, but only 2 of them that are closed are as well as open, and they are nothing but what? The empty set and the set itself. As a final remark, we should note that in every topological space, the empty set and the entire set are always what? Clopen. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not done so already, and kindly share, like, and leave a comment. Thank you, and bye-bye.